So as you're aware, the left atrial appendage is a little embryological vestige that is attached to the left atrium, and it is the most common, or the most important source of clots and strokes in patients who have atrial fibrillation. And it also has arrhythmia-based triggers that are responsible for initiating and maintaining atrial fibrillation in some groups of patients. So it plays a very important role from a stroke standpoint as well as from an arrhythmia standpoint. So there are several technologies that are available to mechanically exclude this particular structure. Some techniques include the open heart surgical procedures or minimally invasive mini thoracotomy procedures where you could ligate the appendage or even deploy an appendageal clip. From a percutaneous minimally invasive stuff, you have implantable endocardial devices like the Watchman device or the Amplatzer cardiac plug or the Wavecrest device and so forth. And then there is another very innovative, creative device called the lariat where you can actually tie up the appendage without having to do any kind of thoracotomy with a minimal pericardial access with a needle. So our group actually had the most experience with the lariat device, and when we tried to use this particular approach of ligating off the appendage as an adjunct therapy to Afib ablation in those patients who have persistent and long-standing persistent atrial fibrillations. So it is a prospective registry of multi-center in nature. We are able to recruit about 62 patients up until this point in time, where we have noticed a significant improvement in the overall response rates to radio frequency ablation in those patients who actually had a left atrial appendage ligation. And we also had less number of TIAs and strokes in this group of patients. So I do believe in patients with non-paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, the left atrial appendage seems to play a very important role in arrhythmia initiation and maintenance, and so mechanically and electrically excluding this particular structure seems to make sense. So we're going to expand this study to multiple centers and to collect a much bigger number to be able to really study the and reconfirm our initial observations. And we also believe that the left atrial appendage also plays a significant role in systemic homeostasis, controlling the blood pressures and those type of things. So when you take out this particular structure, there could be some significant neuroendocrine changes that could also explain the positive benefits that we've been noticing in patients with appendage ligation.
Great.